So the Arduino servo knob project is probably one of the more common beginner builds, and for a good reason, right? It's a very satisfying project, and you can see your results right away. You turn the knob and the servo moves. I spent a minute cruising around YouTube and looking at some of the tutorials to get a sense of where I fit in, and
no, don't do it. Oh God, I hate it so much.
I decided to focus on the build quality of the board and the connections itself. This video is going to assume that you already own an Arduino board, breadboard, jumper wires, and maybe some tools, and also is going to assume that you've already plugged your Arduino board in and know how to upload a sketch to it. I've been teaching electronics and robotics for over a decade now. I find that when I work with students, there's a couple of things that create the most problems, and they're relatively easy to deal with, but I don't see them covered in a lot of other videos, so I'm going to try to deal with them here. In this video, I'm going to be talking about two different kinds of wire to make our connections. We have a flexible, soft silicone wire for all movable connections. When I'm connecting up things like the knob, I'm going to use this. For the onboard connections, I'm going to use solid core wire, which can be bent into shapes and will hold its shape. There's very different wire types, and use the correct type depending on what you're trying to do. There's a couple of components we're going to look at. We're going to look at breadboards today. We're going to look at Arduino in a couple of different formats, right? So there's your different Arduino boards. We're also going to be using servo motors. It's the Arduino servo knob project. So we're going to be using hobby servos. And of course, we're going to have to look at knobs. Knobs. We've got a big honking trim pot here. These are called knobs or trim pots, potentiometers. It's all the same thing. They always have three legs like this, ta-da, or they should, right? And a knob that you can turn. This one's got a nice tall knob on there. Here's another variety, kind of a little bit smaller, but still has a big stick there for me to twist. This little teeny guy here, it's really hard to see, but it's got three legs. And you'd have to turn this one with a screwdriver, probably, because it's so small, right? I'm going to start by talking about how I would finish off a trim pot or knob. I've got a piece of wood that I've drilled a hole, and then that way I can shove the trim pot through and then use the nut that it comes with to bolt it down to there, essentially. I've also purchased a nice, big, red, sexy knob topper there so that you can see which direction it's pointed, and you have something to play with there. On the back, I've soldered on wires and used heat shrink to make sure that they're electrically isolated. I've also used another piece of heat shrink to keep these three wires together to make kind of a tail. I'm using silicone wire here because it's nice and flexible. And I'm using a DuPont connector to create this finished tip with all three wires together. One thing I see too often is someone taking a trim pot like this, your knob, and then maybe taking a jumper wire and shoving it through one of those little holes and then soldering it in place. So instead, I want you to spend maybe just like 20 more minutes, and you might have to buy a couple of tools. But for instance, crimping pliers. This is a pair of crimping pliers. And this crimp tool allows you to put, for instance, this kind of end, a DuPont connector end on your wire. Or you'll notice on a servo motor, that's exactly the kind of connector that that this thing ships with. And that's all the servo motors come with that kind of connector. And I put that same kind of connector on the end of my knob here so that when I'm working on my project, I can just plug and play, right? So let me show you the kind of board that I see students too often build or on too many YouTube videos. Here's an Arduino Uno and a breadboard, and jumpers are used to make all of the connections. So you've got all this extra stuff on top, right? Also, the first thing that's likely to happen is you're accidentally going to unplug something. And now this is a live wire. I just happened to unplug my 5-volt lead there, right? So say goodbye, right? This is the most common cause of death in electronics. So if you like to burn up money, but be careful, and we're gonna upgrade this. For me, the first upgrade would be to use an Arduino Nano. It's a much smaller board. It's got two rows of pins, so you have to jam it down into the breadboard. And if you have to remove it, you have to be careful not to bend its little legs. So I often use a wooden popsicle stick to work up on either end and kind of just work it out of the board slowly. But it's not going to come unplugged. And I've now got all the rest of the board still to work with. I can use the voltage rail on the bottom to pull down the ground and 5 volt from my Arduino board and then give myself a bunch of places to plug in. This allows me to plug my knob and my servo into the 5 volt rail without any extra wires. On the bottom here, I've used the solid core wire bent into kind of a little staple shape. I've stripped both ends and left the insulation in the middle. And that allows me to create these connections on the power side without having anything sticking up. I have kept jumpers for the knob, which is on analog pin 0, and the servo, which is on digital pin 9. That is standard for the Arduino servo knob script, so I've made no changes there. I open up the example and upload it to the board directly with no change. So I don't want to address any of the software in this video because I'm not touching it. I'm just using the Arduino servo knob script as is, and it uses analog pin 0 and digital pin 9. On the other side here, in order to plug in my knob and my servo, I've used a little 3-pin header there. You buy these headers in a sort of a strip, and you cut them to be the size you need. This is a full length. It's long on both sides. If you're going to use a board connection, they also make a one that's half length on one side. Let's run this thing and see what it does. I'm going to be using a USB for power, just my regular 5-volt USB connection. Take a look. Ta-da, power. I am not going to plug anything in while the board is on. Do not plug things in while your board has power. Turn off the power, plug things in. I'm gonna take my little knob here with its 3-pin connector and my servo. I'm gonna use this tiny hobby servo. All right, I've got everything plugged in. I'm gonna use my 5-volt USB power and I turn the knob and the servo turns, sorry. Turn the knob, servo turns, right? So this is really satisfying. Like right away, you turn this and the servo turns, you got a little robot. That's cool to play with. It's like a little toy. And this is very gratifying. It lets you see that everything's working. This is not copacetic. I am using the Arduino's 5-volt power to drive that little motor. This is a no-no because you are putting extra load on the voltage regulator for the Arduino board. The Arduino board should only power itself or maybe input devices like a knob. Motors, LEDs, anything that requires power needs its own power supply. All right, so let's go to the next level upgrade. Here's the same breadboard. Again, an Arduino Nano. Now I've removed all the jumpers. The servo wire on digital pin 9 is now a flat piece of solid core wire. The knob on analog pin 0 is the yellow wire there again, but this time it goes under the board and is tucked in underneath, so I've got nothing sticking up. I've still got some little headers to plug my components into. I have used a little bead of hot glue right down around the heel of each of these so that they are nice and in place and won't come out as I'm plugging things in and out. Another big change is I've added power. So instead of giving it power through the USB connection, now I'm going to give it power through its V-in pin. And you can do this with the Arduino Uno as well. It also has a V-in pin. But I'm going to give it power here through V-in. Then I'm going to give it 12 volts, and it is going to regulate its own voltage. Then I'm going to pass that 12-volt power over to this little voltage regulator or buck converter, and it will pass its voltage, its regulated voltage, up over and to the servo there. This voltage regulator is dialed into 6 volts, which is a decent voltage for a hobby servo. You do not want to give a hobby servo 12 volts. The voltage regulator or buck converter I'm using is this little tiny guy here. There's a whole range of these as well, but I like this one because it's small and it tucks in nicely. The spacing of the holes is not compatible with the breadboards, so when you go to solder these legs, they will come out crooked, but it's okay, and it's much better than having all those jumpers sticking up, right? Let's give this guy a go. For power, I'm going to use a barrel jack for my 12-volt connection, and on the other end, I've got a 2-pin DuPont connector. All right, so now I've got everything plugged in. I'm using the larger more powerful hobby servo. Got the same knob. There we go. And now, just like the other one, I can turn the knob and the servo moves. That's fun though, right? It's cool and it works and you can see your results directly. But what I want you to notice here is that I can do that, right? I can dangle all of the components from my breadboard and nothing comes unplugged and it's still, if I can get it undangled. Yeah, it's still working just fine, right? So you want this level of robustness and durability or else your project isn't there yet. So this is the kind of build quality that I'm looking for in a student project. This is going to allow me to just sort of like unplug everything. Okay, so there you have a good, stable, robust build to support your Arduino servo knob project or other future projects. Please mash those buttons, comment if you got them, and I'll see you next time.